Data center attacks rely on lateral movement to spread to critical systems. Introduced in AOS 5.6, Nutanix Flow with microsegmentation provides a distributed firewall to stop this spread. Welcome to Tech Topics. Today you'll learn how to use Nutanix Flow to secure your data center. Flow consists of three things: VM microsegmentation, which is a distributed firewall; Flow visualization, which allows you to see the traffic that's happening in your network; and service chaining, which allows you to redirect VM traffic to a network function VM. Before Flow, you had to use physical firewalls to secure east-west VM traffic, which was complex and expensive. Flow is built into AHV, so there's nothing to install, and it's easy to manage because it uses Prism Central. Let's start with microsegmentation. To secure traffic between any two VMs, we can use policies and categories in Prism Central to define the allowed traffic flows. In this simple example, we'll secure traffic between two VMs, and we're going to isolate the production environment from the development environment. So let's start with a development VM. And we're going to also create a production virtual machine. These two VMs are going to be assigned categories. And let's use the environment category. So this machine is in the environment of development. And this virtual machine is in the environment of production. I'm going to create a policy in Prism Central that isolates development from production. And so you'll just see that show up as a blocking rule between development and production. Let's see how we build this isolation policy in Prism Central. The isolation policy is a blacklist. So in this case, environment development cannot talk to environment production. If I hover over this, I see the number of flows that have potentially violated this rule from environment dev to environment production. But this policy, again, is in monitoring mode, so that traffic is being allowed and just reported. We could move this policy to the apply mode, and then that traffic would be blocked. With just a few clicks, we can isolate the dev environment from the prod environment. Let's add a few more categories to these VMs so we can create a more granular policy. So the development VM is part of application type A, and it's part of the application tier web. So that makes this a development web server, part of application A. The production VM is still part of app type A, and it's also a production web server. So let's look at how we can use an application policy to secure traffic in this application. Our application security policy is going to protect a three-tier application called App A. So we're going to use the category App Type A from our previous example. The three tiers are web, so we're going to use the app tier web, the app tier app, and finally the app tier database. So we're going to allow some inbound connectivity to our application. So we're going to allow all connections inbound from any sources to our web, app, and database tiers. On the outbound side, we're going to allow connectivity to an Active Directory server and a DNS server. So let's draw them on the outbound side. So to allow these connections, let's open up some ports here for our web server to talk to Active Directory and DNS. And let's allow all of the other tiers in our application to talk to the AD server. So just like that, I've created an application policy that allows me to secure communication from inbound sources and outbound sources. All I need to do to place VMs inside of this security policy is assign these categories to the VMs. I can also secure traffic within the application itself. So let's allow some communication from the web tier to the application tier. And then also allow communication from the app tier to the database tier. So now I've created a model of all the communication that my three-tier application needs to have for functionality. Let's show how we build that application inside Prism Central. Here we have an application policy with three tiers. It's app type A with a web, app, and database tier. We allow all inbound sources and are blocking all but just these two outbound destinations. So we're allowing communication from the app tier to Active Directory, and all of the other items in yellow are flows that we've been detecting but are not actually specified within our policy. So right now, this is a policy that's in monitoring mode. These flows are allowed. But let's take a look, for instance, at our web virtual machine. It's trying to make some connections to this server on the DNS port. So I'm trying to build this policy, and I've built it in monitor mode, but what I realize is that maybe my web server should be able to connect to DNS. So I can come in here, update the policy, and then look at the detected flow from the web tier to DNS. I can easily add that flow into the policy, and then from there, the web now is allowed to talk to DNS. And then I can save that policy. So I built out a three-tier application called App A with a web, app, and database tier, and then applied a security policy. If I look at my production web server, what I'll notice is that I just used some simple categories to make this particular VM part of the policy. So this production web server is in environment production. It's in the app type of application A, and it has an app tier value of web. So this makes this a production web server in app A. On the right-hand side, I see that these policies are evaluated in real time. So for example, this is in environment production. There's an isolation policy called isolate dev from production, and that applies to this virtual machine. There's also the App A security policy that applies. This is a real-time evaluated list of policies. If I remove the environment production from a policy, what I see is that this policy no longer applies because the category has been removed. That's how you define your application with Prism Central. You can also use Flow to integrate with a network function VM via service chaining. So in our previous example, we had the app tier, app, and it was talking to an Active Directory server. So we'll draw the Active Directory server over here. And if we were using service chaining to integrate with a network function VM, we might want to route that traffic through something like an intrusion detection VM. So this IDS is installed on every AHV host as a bump in the wire. We can check a single box in the application policy to route all of the traffic from the app tier app through the IDS on its way to the Active Directory server. That transparently forwards the traffic so that the app tier app has no idea its traffic is being redirected through the IDS. Let's show how that's set up in Prism Central. If I look at App A security policy and go into the update screen here, I notice that I can control all of the traffic from the app tier of App A and choose the different destinations for that traffic. So one of these destinations is Active Directory. And if I want to choose what type of traffic is allowed to Active Directory, I can edit that flow here. I've allowed all traffic from app to Active Directory. But let's say that I don't entirely trust the app tier of this application, and I'd like to run this through an extra sort of security filter. I can just choose redirect through security chain, and now this particular traffic flow from app to Active Directory will be sent through the intrusion detection system that I'm running on this Nutanix AHV system. So with just a couple clicks, I can make sure that specific flows are now redirected through an intrusion detection system. This is actually a cost-effective way to redirect traffic through intrusion detection or through a firewall, because these firewalls have potentially a limited amount of bandwidth that they can process over any given period. So we can just redirect traffic that's critical to be inspected through these services, thus making sure we have more resources available and we get the most out of these monitoring systems. So then I can save the policy, and I can even move this policy into an apply mode. So in apply mode, I now know that my policy is complete and it's going to start blocking traffic. So before I was monitoring so that I could build the policy, and now in apply mode, only the traffic that I've defined is going to be allowed through the policy. Anything that's not defined is going to be blocked. Any VM that runs on AHV can be used as a network function VM for service chaining. We can also use Flow to quarantine virtual machines, and there are two types of quarantine. So we have a forensics quarantine and a strict quarantine mode. The strict quarantine blocks all traffic into and out of VMs that are quarantined, and the forensics mode allows access for certain VMs. In this case, let's say that our security operations team still wants to access VMs. So we'll allow our security operations team access over on TCP port 22 to any VM that's forensics quarantined. All outbound traffic from any quarantine forensics VM would still be blocked. And for the strict mode, all traffic is blocked in and out. So this allows our security team to access anything that's been forensics quarantined so they can investigate what went wrong, while all traffic in the strict quarantine mode is blocked. Let's show how we can set this policy up. If I go to the Explore tab, you'll see that I have my normal list of virtual machines. Let's say that my mailbox administrator comes to me and says that he's detected a virus on the Exchange Mailbox virtual machine. We could immediately start using microsegmentation with the quarantine policy. So we'll navigate to Actions, Quarantine VMs, and you'll note that there are actually two methods for quarantining this virtual machine. We could use a strict quarantine or a forensic quarantine. If we place the VM into strict quarantine, we'll expect that it should be cut off from the rest of the network. We can then navigate into the security policies and see what the strict quarantine has actually done for us. So here, there is one virtual machine under strict quarantine, and we'll note that there's some traffic both on the inbound side and on the outbound side for that quarantined virtual machine. If I hover over any one of these inbound connections, I can see all of the ports and protocols that were attempted to connect to this specific quarantined virtual machine. Same thing on the outbound side. So all of these items in red are a connection that was attempted from this virtual machine that's quarantined that was blocked. So we see the destination in red, and if we click on the flow, we can see a histogram over time of when those connections were attempted. So over this prior period in time, these connections were attempted to the VM, but blocked. If I look at the forensic mode, what I note here is that I've allowed the security operations environment to connect to VMs that are forensic quarantined. So strict quarantine is entirely cut off, but the forensic quarantine has one group that's allowed to investigate that specific VM. With Flow, you can use policies and categories to secure traffic between VMs, look at the traffic on the network, and even integrate with network function virtual machines. Enable Flow inside of Prism Central, and for more information, visit the Nutanix support portal and search for Flow. Thanks for watching Tech Topics. Be sure to subscribe for more great Nutanix videos.